What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. Today in this tutorial we will learn how to uninstall Oracle Database 18c from your Windows 10. In this video, I will demonstrate the manual process of uninstalling which will help you wipe out Oracle Database 18c completely from your machine. Let me also tell you that the process of uninstalling Oracle Database 18c will remain the same for both Microsoft Windows 10 64-bit as well as Windows 10 32-bit. Thus, you can follow the steps and enjoy the tutorial. So, without wasting much of your time, let's start. But first, make sure that you are logged on to your Windows with an administrative user. In order to carry out the process of uninstalling Oracle 18c, you will require administrative privileges. Not having those will disturb or halt the uninstallation of your Oracle Database 18c. So go ahead and log on to your Windows with an administrative account if you haven't already. Once you are done with that, you are all set to start the uninstallation. Speaking about privileges, now you have a chance to learn new skills to improve your resume and boost your career through Skillshare, our sponsor for today's video. Skillshare is an online learning community with hundreds of high quality classes by experts from around the world. I used it to learn SEO and digital media marketing. Its short and precise courses helped me in enhancing my knowledge and I really found it helpful. You can use Skillshare to learn skills like Java, data science and analytics, computer networking, Android and iOS app development, and many more. And the best part is that you don't need to pay individually for each course. Just pay for the premium membership and take as many different classes as you want. That makes it an extremely affordable learning community in the market. And the good news is that the first 500 people who join Skillshare through my link, which is given in the description, will get the premium membership for 2 months absolutely free. So go ahead, sign up and stay on top of the game with Skillshare. That being said, let's get back to our uninstallation. Step 1. Delete the environment variable. If you are planning to reinstall any version of Oracle Database, then getting rid of environment variable is not only important but also recommended. Not deleting environment variable will cause an error while reinstallation, which will say environment variable path is too long. So let's see how to delete Oracle Database 18c's environment variable. First, you need to go to the properties of your Windows. For that, right click on your This PC icon and select Properties. Once you are into the properties of your computer, then select Advanced System Settings from the left hand side bar. Doing so will open up the system properties. In your system properties windows, there is a button called Environment Variable at the bottom of the Advanced tab. Click it. This will open up the Environment Variable window. Great. In this window, we have two sections, which are User Variables and System Variables. Come to the System Variables section and find a variable with the name path. Now you have to double click on this path variable. This will open up the Edit Environment Variable window. And here it is. Here we have our Edit Environment Variable window. Unlike previous versions, in Windows 10, environment variables are better organized. Anyways, from this list of environment variables, you need to find the one which has the location of DB Home. In my case, the environment variable for my Oracle database looks something like this. In your case also, it should look more or less similar to this string. But depending on your installation, it can be different. Whatsoever, at least you get the idea. But still, if you are confused, then check out the previous video where I have shown a nifty trick to find out the DB Home location and SID of your Oracle database. Link is in the description. Anyways, now select the string you want to delete and press the delete button. That's all you have to do in the first step. Now let's move on to the second step. But first, let's press the OK button of all these windows and come out from them. Done. Step 2. Delete the registries of Oracle Database 18c. In order to completely delete the Oracle Database 18c, we need to delete all the major Windows registries associated with it. This step is very crucial and meticulous. You have got to be very careful while deleting the registries. One wrong move can cause severe damages. So I suggest you to take a backup of your registries before moving ahead. You can learn how to take the backup of your Windows registries and other interesting stuff by reading the blog on the same topic on my website. Link is in the description. That being said, now let's see how to delete the Windows registries for Oracle Database 18c and which one we need to delete. First, open up your run command box by pressing Windows key and R key simultaneously. In order to open up the registry editor in your Windows, you have to write regedit regedit in your run dialog box. Now press OK. Here we are. There are two sets of registries that we have to delete here. First one is for Oracle Database 18c software, and another one is for all those services which runs in the background and are responsible for proper working of your Oracle database. Let's start with the latter option and delete the registries for Oracle Database services first. To delete these service registries, first go to hkey local machine directory and then go to system subdirectory. After that, go to current control set and then services. Here in this service directory, you will find all the registries which we will have to delete. In order to find the registries for Oracle Database services from this list, press alphabet O on your keyboard. And navigation will take you to all those registries whose name starts with O. And luckily, all the Oracle Database registries' name starts with the word Oracle. Let's press O and see how many registries for Oracle Database 18c we have here. Okay, let's scroll down a little bit. Great. For Oracle Database 18c, we only have 6 Windows registries. To delete these registries, right click on them and choose delete. Press yes and move ahead. Do the same with all the remaining 5 registries. Okay, all the Windows registries for Oracle Database 18c background services have been deleted. Next, we have to delete the Windows registries for Oracle Database software. Let's do that. Once again, I am in my Windows Registry Editor. In order to delete the Windows Registry for Oracle Database software, you again need to go to hkey local machine folder. And this time, go to the folder software. The name of the registry which we are looking for here is Oracle. So again, press alphabet O and find the same. Here it is. Okay. Let me first expand this registry for you. Before deleting this registry, make sure only Oracle Database 18c software is installed in your system. In case you have other software from Oracle installed, then take a good look at the content of this folder and delete only those associated with Oracle Database 18c. In my case, I have only Oracle Database 18c installed on this machine. Thus, I will delete this entire folder. Windows registry for Oracle Database software is deleted. That's all you have to do in this step. Now, let's move to the next step, which is restart your system. As we have deleted all the major Windows registries associated with our Oracle Database 18c, thus in order to bring these changes to effect, we must restart our system. That's exactly what I'm going to do now. I will be back in a second. By the magic of video editing, I am back. My system is restarted and all set to move to the next step. Step 4. Delete the Oracle Home user and groups. If you remember, while installing Oracle Database 18c, we created a dedicated Windows user which Oracle Server uses for handling all the Oracle user groups. To uninstall the Oracle Database 18c, we need to delete that Oracle Home user as well as all the Oracle user groups from our Windows 10. Let's do that. In order to delete the user and groups, we first need to open the local users and groups window. The fastest way to launch the local users and groups window is through run command box. Thus, launch your run command box by pressing Windows key and R key simultaneously. This will open up your run command box. Next, you have to write a command in this box to open the local users and groups window. And that command will be lusr mgr.msc. Now press OK and that will open your users and group window. Great, here we are. In this window, you have to go to this users directory. Double click and open it. Here, you will get the list of all the users created in your Windows operating system. From this list, you have to delete the user which you have created during the installation of your Oracle 18c. In my case, I remember Rebellion Rider is the user which I created while installing the Oracle Database 18c on my machine. Thus, I will delete this user. Great! User deleted. Now that we have deleted the user, next we have to delete all the groups associated with our Oracle 18c. For that, we have to go to this groups directory. Here we are. Similar to the user directory, here we have got the list of all the user groups created in our Windows operating system. From this list, we need to delete only those groups which are associated just with our Oracle Database 18c. Now the question here is, which groups should we delete from this list? Since the name of all the Oracle Database 18c groups starts with ORA, thus we will delete only those which have ORA prefixed to their names. Once again, if along with Oracle 18c, there are other software from Oracle installed on your system, then be careful to delete only those that are being shown to you on the screen. Let me scroll down and zoom in a little bit to show you all the groups whose name starts with a prefix ORA. For your convenience, I will leave the name of all the Oracle Database 18c groups in the corresponding blog. You can find the link in the description. Anyways, there are a total of 15 groups which have their names starting with a prefix ORA. We need to delete all these 15 groups. Let's do that. Great, all of them are deleted. That's all we have to do in this step. Now let's move to the next step. Step 5, delete the DB home. Now that we have deleted all the Windows registries associated with our Oracle Database 18c, so we are free to delete all the Oracle Database files and folders from our Windows 10. Let's do that. I had installed my Oracle 18c on my D drive. Let's go there. As you can see here in my D drive that I have two folders. One is my DB home and another one is app. This app directory is actually the Oracle base. We need to delete both of these folders. Just select them and press delete. In case you are not able to delete them, then first make sure you are logged on to your Windows using an administrative account. Second, chances are there that your system may have a pending restart, so restart your machine and try again. Seems like we have two big directories. Let's delete them permanently. Both the directories have been deleted, but there is one more directory which we have to delete. For that, we first need to go to our C drive and then go to the folder Program Files. Here, search for the folder with the name Oracle. Here it is. Let's delete it. Done. Now, let's close this window. As you can see, we have deleted all the directories and with that, we have wiped out the entire Oracle Database 18c from our Windows 10 operating system manually as well as properly. So, this is the proper manual uninstallation of Oracle Database 18c. After this, you will be free to install any Oracle Database version on your Windows without formatting it. That's the tutorial on how to uninstall Oracle 18c from Windows 10. Hope you enjoyed watching and found it helpful. Please give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends on your social media. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionWriter.com.